Good morning, everyone. It is January 25th. We are doing second committee, health committee agenda, health committee for the New York State Senate. We're joined by Senator Rath, Senator Overacker, Senator Salazar, Senator Steck, Senator Ryan, Senator Thomas, Senator Boyle, Senator Benjamin Kaminsky, Brooke, and Biagi. We'll also be joined by our ranking member, Senator Gallivan, is running a couple of minutes late, but he will be here shortly. But we do have quorum, so we will get started. I will also, even though you can't necessarily see to the side of me, there is the new
Senator Hoylman is here.
Senator Hoylman as well. Okay. Probably on kid duty, which is why you're not on camera. Perfectly understood. Although you can't see it to my left, we have a new committee director, Michaela Panicia, who has been part of the central staff for a few years, and she will now be joining my staff as committee director. Welcome to her, even though you can't see her on screen. I'm very glad to have you as part of the team, Ms. Panicia. All right, so we'll start with Senate Bill 238 by Senator Thomas. If this bill is reported, we'll go to first reading.
An act to amend the social services law.
Okay, we'll get that technical thing fixed. This is a Senator Thomas bill. Senator Thomas, would you like to comment on this bill, sir?
Sure. This is an incredibly important bill. It has passed the Senate a number of years. It's failed in the Assembly, and it's even more important now, given that we're living in a pandemic. This deals with a constituent of mine that lives in Garden City. He was skateboarding and fell and had a traumatic brain injury and has been paralyzed since. His mom is a registered nurse and has been taking care of him. So currently the law says that anyone like a family member who's taking care of one of their family members who's sick will only be reimbursed at a personal assistant rate. And I want to change that so that someone who is a nurse who knows more about the situation will be reimbursed at a nurse's rate. And I believe this bill is incredibly important for the pandemic that we're living through right now.
Thank you, Senator Thomas. Any questions or other comments about the bill? All right, do I have a motion? I have a motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Salazar. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Aye. Without rec, that bill is, congratulations, Senator Thomas. It is reported to first reading. Now get to work on the Assembly, huh? A few of those. Next bill by Senator Benjamin, Senate Bill 591. If it is reported, it'll go to first reading.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to training for prescribers of certain medications.
All right, Senator Thomas, you have any, I know you were on the screen a second ago. If you're still with us, would you like to say anything about this bill?
I'm sorry, which one is this?
Oh, I'm sorry, not Senator Thomas, Senator Benjamin. Senator Benjamin. There you go. You're muted, sir.
No, I don't, Mr. Salazar.
All righty. So as pretty self-explanatory, relates to the training requirements for folks who prescribe certain pain medications. Any questions or comments about the bill? Okay. Do I have a motion?
Move the bill.
Motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Brooke. All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Without rec? That bill is reported to first reading. Next bill, Senate Bill 677A by Senator Harkin. If reported, it will go to first reading.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to the reporting of Lyme and tick-borne diseases infection after death.
Again, it is a it's pretty self-explanatory. If somebody is perishes, so that folks, a coroner or pathologist, could determine if that person determines that person was had Lyme disease, that would be reported to the department along with anything else that needs to be reported from their as it relates to their death. Any questions or comments on this bill? Okay, do I have a motion? Motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Overacker. All those in favor? Aye. Aye. Opposed? Without rec, that bill is reported to first reading. Next, from Senator Hoylman, Senate Bill 723.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to authorizing the presence of epinephrine auto-injector devices on preschool premises and on restaurant premises.
Right. I believe that Senator Hoylman might still be in the room. If so, Senator Hoylman, would you like to comment anything on your bill? And Hoylman is on kid duty.
No. I'm here. It's self-explanatory, Senator. Thank you.
All righty. And again, as Senator Hoylman said, it is indeed self-explanatory, just authorizes the presence of epinephrine injectors in preschool premises. Any questions or comments about the bill? Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Motion by Senator Rath, seconded by Senator Biagi. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Without rec? That bill is reported to first reading. Next bill by Senator Ramos, 1043A. If reported out of this committee, it would go to finance.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to requiring cafeteria staff to be trained in preventing and responding to anaphylaxis.
And again, it is self-explanatory. It just changes some of the criteria for training for cafeteria staff as it refers to anaphylactic shock. Do I have any questions or comments about the bill? All right, do I have a motion? Motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Salazar. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed?
Opposed.
Got a couple of opposed, Senator Rath, Senator Steck, Senator Overacker. Any other opposition? All right, without rec. All righty, that bill is reported. Right? Yep. All right, that bill is reported to finance. Next, my bill, Senate Bill 1409, if reported out of this committee, it will go referred to finance.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to establishing the Infant Recovery Center's pilot program and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof.
We passed this a couple of times before, and it refers to four centers, to four infant recovery centers around the state. There is some money that's appropriated for it. So certainly I hope that we can get it passed and signed this bill this year. Do I have any questions or comments about this bill? All right, do I have a motion? Motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Salazar. All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
In opposition? Without rec? That bill, did I hear without rec? No, okay, that bill is reported to finance. Next bill, again, my bill 1578, would be reported to first reading.
An act to amend the social services law in relation to including applied behavioral analysis for treatment of autism spectrum disorder under standard coverage for Medicaid recipients.
Again, pretty self-explanatory. We have passed it before. It's just to expand applied behavioral analysis to folks to spectrum autism spectrum disorder. Medicaid patients who have autism spectrum disorder. Any questions or comments on this bill? Do I have a motion? Motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Brook. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec?
Without rec.
Without rec, Senator Roth. Is it Roth or Rath?
Rath.
Rath. Senator Rath, Senator Steck, and Senator Oberacker.
Roz the Assemblyman, Rath the Senator.
I'm trying to get this, bro. I'm trying to get this.
Good. Anyway, it's all good.
Those three without recs. Any other without recs? No? Okay. That bill is reported to first reading. Next, Senate Bill 1592, also by me. Go ahead.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to the appointment of the state Medicaid director.
And this, I've been carrying this for the last couple of years. It is my belief that such an important position as Medicaid director should be appointed by the governor, but should be approved by the Senate. So that person could go to the same process that things like judges and other folks in the governor's cabinet go through. It is in a very, very important position, hoping that we can get it passed this year. I'm not sure if it'll get signed, but you know, one step at a time, I figure. Any questions or comments on that bill? All right. Do I have a motion? Say a motion for Senator Salazar, seconded by Senator Biaggi. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec? All right. That bill is reported to first reading. The last bill has actually been put on hold. There's some conversations that I want to have with the sponsor about some of the what this bill does and how it does it, but we will definitely see it very likely see it in future committee agendas. That's 1774. So for the moment, that bill is held, and that would be it. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This meeting is adjourned.